In this video, we'll cover all the basics of using the ASP.NET MVC Data Editor's extensions. I have an MVC project here with a home controller, data model, and an empty index view. Let's run this and see what it looks like in the browser. As you can see, the content area is empty, so let's return to Visual Studio. Let's add a DevExpress MVC extension in our view. In the view file, I right-click on the position where I want the DevExpress MVC extension to be defined. Next, in the context menu, I select the Insert DevExpress MVC extension item and the Insert Extension wizard appears. Here, let's select the trackbar extension. I leave the default extension name and minimum value, set the maximum value to 100, and select the vertical orientation, but I won't bind it to a data model. In additional settings, I define the scale position and allow range selection. Finally, I click Insert. You can see that the wizard inserted all the required code for me. Let's take a look at the trackbar editor settings. Visual Studio IntelliSense helps us here. I can define the extension name, its width or height, and the editor-specific settings that are accessible via the Properties property. Let's also define the trackbar height here. I set it to 400 pixels. Let's take a look at the result in the browser. Here you can see the fully functional trackbar extension that allows you to select ranges of values. Let's close the browser and return to Visual Studio and delete the trackbar from the view. Next, I'll demonstrate features that are common for all text box-based data editors, such as the text box, button edit, spin edit, and more. The first common feature is null text. Null text is the prompt text displayed within the editor's input box when the editor is not focused and its value is null. I add the text box with the empty null text property. I can edit the inserted code manually. Let's set it to the words type here. The second common feature is the display format string. That is the pattern used to format the editor's value for display purposes. I add the text box extension and define its display format string and set it to the character C, which will show it as a currency value. The third feature is mask editing. Masks are useful when a string entered by an end user into an editor should match a specific format. I add the text box extension, define its mask, and set it to mask for phone numbers. Let's take a look at the result. Here you can see three text boxes. The first one displays null text that disappears when the editor is in focus. The second text box displays end user input in currency format. When the editor is in focus, the user input is displayed in the initial format. The third text box allows me to input phone numbers respective to the mask. Even if I delete the editor text, the mask is still displayed. The DevExpress data editors can be seamlessly integrated into the ASP.NET MVC infrastructure. Let's return to the project and delete the index.cshtml file. We'll generate it later. In this project, I have a data model class, which describes a person. These class properties are decorated with data annotation attributes. The home controller contains a function that returns a list of strings, and two actions that handle GET and POST requests depending on their attributes. The action that handles POST requests checks whether the model instance that came from the view is valid and returns the result OK view if it is. DevExpress MVC data editors fully support two-way data binding. Let's define the default person name via the action. I create a new person instance and define its name. For example, test name. And then I pass this value to the view as a model. Okay, now let's add a view. I right-click the action code and select the Add View item. In the Add View dialog, I specify the view name, specify that this view should be strongly typed, select the model class, and the scaffold template. All the required libraries are already referenced, so I uncheck the corresponding option. Then I click Add. The ASP.NET MVC editors generated the edit form for me. Here you can see that the HTML.editor4 method is used, and it displays data editors for model data fields using the required editor template. All the custom editor template files are located in the editor template subfolder in the Views Shared Project folder. Each template file has the same name as a corresponding data type. Here you can see the templates for editing Boolean values, date time values, etc. I created this project using the DevExpress project template wizard, so the wizard automatically created the data editor templates and I didn't need to create them manually. Let's take a look at the result in the browser. Here you can see that some of the field editors are rendered with editor templates, and some of them, email and age fields, are rendered as standard input elements. Next, let's look at the project data model. As you can see, the email field has the email address attribute and the age field is of integer type. But here we have no editor templates to edit emails or integers. Instead of creating these templates, let's make use of a helpful MVC feature called strongly typed data editors. Let's return to the view code, and within the age field, I replace the editor4 method with the DevExpress spin-edit4 extension, which allows us to edit numeric values with ease. For the email field, we can use the DevExpress textbox4 editor. As I mentioned previously, we have a list of strings that can be used within the edit form. I'll pass this list using the dynamic viewbag data dictionary property of ASP.NET MVC. We'll pass it from the controller to the view. We can use the DevExpress combobox4 data editor to empower end users with the ability to select one of the predefined values. The editor items are bound to the position list via the bindList method. The native submit input is used to submit the form. We can use the DevExpress button to provide a consistent appearance through the project. I specify the extension name and enable the use submit behavior option. Let's take a look at the result. Now, as you can see, end users have the ability to select a position and pick the required date via the date edit extension. You can see that client-side validation notifies me that the email address I've entered is not valid. Let's return and correct it. When the value is valid, the error message disappears. The spin edit allows me to easily edit numeric values by typing the required value or by clicking spin buttons. When I click the button, the OK view opens and notifies me that the submitted values are correct. The DevExpress MVC editors have the Show Model Errors property, which allows, when enabled, error messages to be automatically displayed within invalid editors when validation fails. Using a built-in error message placeholder instead of the standard validation message for allows you to flexibly control how errors should be displayed within editors. Here, I can specify that a combo box should display error text with an image and allow displaying model errors. Let's take a look at the result. When I try to submit the form without filling the required fields, the error messages appear. Pay special attention to the combo box error message. It shows the error text and an image. This allows us to visualize validation errors more effectively. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.